So today's topic is general considerations with regard to fiber properties. As I have mentioned, we will take one by one these properties and the points which are going to affect them. The properties we are going to consider here is fiber tenacity, which we have already taken. What is the meaning of tenacity? Elastic plastic nature of fiber means elasticity. Hygroscopic nature, mainly moisture absorption and static electricity resistance. Thermal properties, means melting point, softening point, different temperatures at which fibers are having different behaviors. And chemical properties, because textile materials are exposed to different chemicals. So these chemical properties of textile fibers is also considered as an important property. These five properties are considered as important properties of textile fibers. So what are the considerations? What are the points which are going to affect these five properties? So we are taking general considerations. However, there are so many factors of the structure of the fiber, morphology of the fiber, and in case of natural fibers, weather conditions, in which atmosphere we are getting them. All those are going to affect the fiber properties, but here we will consider only the general considerations, which are used for almost all type of fibers for these five properties. So we will take general considerations mean generally it is taking place, but sometimes some exceptions or some other things may affect it. So we are taking general considerations. And in that, what are the general considerations which are going to affect fiber tenacity? Means textile fiber ka tenacity kya hoga finally? It will be a stronger fiber, it will be a moderate fiber, or it will be a weaker fiber. That is influenced by few considerations or few points which we are discussing in this slide. Fiber tenacity is in general. General means maximum time, not always. Fiber tenacity is in general directly related to the length of its polymers. The first point is tenacity kis par depend karta hai? Polymers ki length ke upar. And that's why length of polymer jo humne already liya tha, requirements of fiber forming polymer. Wahan par humne is point ko liya tha, length of the polymer. So this length of the polymer is an important factor which is going to affect fiber tenacity. And that's why we have taken this length of a polymer into requirements of fiber forming polymers. So this is one of the requirement. And that's why length of the polymer becomes very important, becomes significant as far as tenacity is concerned. Second point which is going to affect tenacity is degree of polymerization, that is DP. Degree of polymerization or degree of polymer orientation. Degree of polymer orientation means percentage of crystalline regions and amorphous regions within the polymer system of fiber. So second point is degree of polymer orientation means how much crystalline regions and how much amorphous regions are found in that particular fiber. Cotton is having different degree of polymer orientation. Wool is having different, silk, nylon, polyester, all the fibers which we will study in this semester, in this subject, are having different orientation, or you can say different degree of polymer orientation, or you can say proportion of crystalline and amorphous regions. So first is length, second is degree of polymer orientation, crystalline regions and amorphous regions, and the third important point which is going to affect tenacity is number and types of interpolymer forces of attraction formed between polymers. We have taken this topic also, types of interpolymer forces generally occurring between the polymers of textile fibers, that is van der Waals forces of attraction, hydrogen bonds, ionic bonds and covalent bonds. So what type of bonds or what type of interpolymer forces of attraction are existing within the polymers of a particular fiber, and what is the number of that? Both the things are going to affect tensile strength, that is tenacity. So in general, we can say the longer the polymer, means higher the length of the polymer, more crystalline can be their orientation. length is going to affect degree of polymer orientation. So crystalline regions will get increased. And if more crystalline is the orientation of the fiber, stronger may be the interpolymer forces of attraction formed between them, and that is resulting in the stronger fiber. So longer the polymer, more crystalline the orientation. And if these two things are fulfilled, then number and types of interpolymer forces is going to affect, and that is going to affect the strength of the fiber or the textile material which is formed from that fiber. So if we have higher length of the polymers, if we have more crystalline regions, and if we have stronger type of bonds and their number is also high, then it is going to produce a very strong fiber. And if it is lacking, means length of the polymer is smaller, degree of polymer orientation is more amorphous, and number and types of interpolymer forces of attraction are less, then it is going to be a weaker fiber. So this is tenacity. So tenacity is affected by polymer length, polymer orientation, and types and number of interpolymer forces of attraction. And we will study these three points, three qualities, three dimensions of all the fibers. So if you know these dimensions, then you can say something about the tenacity of that fiber. You can decide tenacity of that fiber. And if tenacity is given, you can understand that these things are found in that fiber, which is giving this type of tenacity or tensile strength. The second property, elastic plastic nature of fibers, means elasticity property. That introduction or definition already we have taken. What is elasticity? A fiber with a crystalline polymer system, and when we have taken the orientation point in the requirements of fiber forming polymers, at that time we have discussed if a crystalline polymer system is there, what will be the properties? If amorphous polymer system is there, what will be the properties? So how it is going to affect the elastic plastic nature, the crystalline and amorphous regions? A fiber with a crystalline polymer system means, the fiber polymer system is having higher crystalline regions. If higher crystalline regions are there, it tends to be stiff and inflexible. More the crystalline fibers, more the proportion of crystalline regions within the polymer system of fiber, the fiber will be stiff and inflexible. Almost both the terms are having same meaning. Inflexible means also stiff. The fiber will be stiff, means less elastic due to restricted polymer movement. Reason is because more crystalline regions means lesser gap between the polymers is there. It means lesser gap means the polymer cannot easily move. So the polymer movement is restricted, and due to this restricted polymer movement, the fibers will be stiff and inflexible if it is having more crystalline polymer system, just like polyester, which is a very crystalline fiber. So it is having less restricted polymer movement, and that's why it is considered as a stiff or less flexible fiber as compared to other fibers which are having amorphous polymer system. Excessive bonding and stretching of such a fiber tends to cause polymer rupture. Agar hum aise fibers ke upar jyada bending forces lagayenge, या ज्यादा हम उसको स्ट्रेच करेंगे, तो वहां पर उस फाइबर के अंदर पॉलीमर रप्चर्स क्रिएट होंगे, पॉलीमर रप्चर हो जाएगा, उसकी वजह से वीक रीजंस फाइबर में क्रिएट होंगे. इफ वी आर पुटिंग एक्सेसिव फोर्सेस और एक्सेसिव स्ट्रेचिंग ऑन द टेक्सटाइल मटेरियल्स व्हिच आर फॉर्मड फ्रॉम सच फाइबर्स, सो हायर क्रिस्टलिनिटी इज ऑल्सो नॉट अ वेरी गुड पॉइंट फॉर अ टेक्सटाइल फाइबर, बिकॉज इट इज गोइंग टू अफेक्ट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी, दैट इज इलास्टिसिटी in adverse mode. Now here, elastic plastic behavior of amorphous polymer fibers. A more amorphous polymer system has sufficiently large interpolymer spaces. Amorphous polymer system means polymers ke beech mein gap jyada hain. So it is having large interpolymer spaces, not interpolymer forces. Interpolymer forces and spaces are different thing. Agar space jyada hain, तो इंटरपॉलीमर फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन कम होंगे. अगर इंटरपॉलीमर स्पेस कम है, तो इंटरपॉलीमर फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन ज्यादा होंगे. So a more amorphous polymer system has sufficiently large interpolymer spaces into which polymers can be displaced. और अगर space ज़्यादा है तो displacement easy होगा, polymers will displaced easily. And when the fiber is bent or stretched, जब fiber को हम bend करेंगे या stretch करेंगे तो उस समय पर displacement easily होगा, जो कि possible नहीं है crystalline polymer system के अंदर. Such polymer displacement will be seen as wrinkling and distortion of the textile material produced from the fiber. इस fiber से जो भी हम textile material बनाएंगे तो उसमें wrinkles ज़्यादा होंगे, distortion ज़्यादा होगा. And you can understand with the help of example, that is viscose fiber. Viscose fiber is having around 65% amorphous polymer system, 65% amorphous regions and 35% crystalline regions. So if you know about the amorphous and crystalline region of the fiber, you can predict its elasticity. And it will have more distortions, means elasticity, and it will create more wrinkles in the textile. The third important property, that is hygroscopic nature, which is related with absorption of water or moisture. So hygroscopic nature depends on particularly few considerations which we are going to discuss here. Hygroscopic nature of a fiber is directly related to the polarity of its polymers. The polymers are polar or non-polar. Means some of the groups of the polymers, some of the groups in the polymer is polar. Then polar, if it is having good polarity, then it will attract the water molecules. And the ratio of its amorphous and crystalline regions. Again, the orientation of the polymers सिस्टम की क्रिस्टलाइन रीजंस ज्यादा हैं या अमोर्फस रीजंस ज्यादा हैं. सो दिस क्रिस्टलाइन रीजंस एंड अमोर्फस रीजंस, द प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ दिस टू इन द पॉलीमर सिस्टम ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर फाइबर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी. सो वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस क्रिस्टलाइन अमोर्फस रीजंस वेरी वेल सो दैट वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉपर्टीज वेरी वेल. सो हाइग्रोस्कोपिक नेचर ऑफ अ फाइबर इज डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड विद टू थिंग्स. वन इज polarity of its polymers and the ratio of its amorphous and crystalline regions. These two are the deciding factors about hygroscopic nature of any textile fiber. If a fiber is very hygroscopic, highly hygroscopic, it means it is having polar polymers as well as it is having more amorphous regions so that water molecules can easily enter into the polymer system of the fiber. If more crystalline, means hygroscopic nature will be adversely affected, means it will be more hydrophobic. And if the amorphous regions are more, then it means it is more hydrophilic. And polarity is also going to affect it. Polarity means polar polymers attract the water molecules. And amorphous regions allow easy entry of those molecules. So if those both the properties are there, if both the things are available in a fiber, it will enhance, it will increase hygroscopic nature. Means it will make the fiber more hydrophilic in nature. And if these are in lesser content, then it will adversely affect and the fiber will be more hydrophobic, not hydrophilic. Hydrophobic means less water attraction. Hydrophilic means more water attraction or more water absorption. Second is, a hygroscopic or absorbent fiber tends to have a predominantly amorphous polymer system of polar polymers. Polar polymers attract water molecules, while the amorphous nature allows entry of the water molecules into the polymer system, which I have already explained. So these two points will increase hygroscopic or hydrophilic character in the fiber and make it less hydrophobic. And a very good example of this, like viscose. Viscose and cotton both are having polar polymers because due to hydroxyl groups found in the polymer of the cotton, viscose and all the these cellulosic fibers. So they will have polar polymers and the ratio of the amorphous and crystalline regions. So you can understand this thing with the help of viscose and cotton. Cotton is having 65% crystalline regions and 35% amorphous regions. Whereas this viscose is having 65% amorphous and 35% crystalline regions. So because more amorphous regions are there in the viscose fiber as compared to cotton fiber. The hygroscopic nature of viscose, so the moisture absorption percent expressed in percentage will be higher for viscose. Viscose is having around 11 to 13% moisture regain, whereas cotton is having around 8 to 8.5% moisture regain. And this difference in the behavior of this hygroscopic behavior between cotton and viscose can be understood with the help of this, that the proportion of amorphous and crystalline regions. And both are cellulosic, so both are polar in nature, and that's why both the fibers are good having good hygroscopic properties. But cotton is less hygroscopic as compared to viscose. However, both the fibers are considered as having good hygroscopic behaviors as compared to other fibers. We will take the question at the end, so please don't raise the hand. One more example here we can take, that is nylon. Nylon is having polar polymers, but it is a highly crystalline fiber, and that's why moisture absorption of nylon is around 3 to 4% only, lesser than cotton even. And if you see cotton polyester, it is not having any polar polymers and very highly crystalline fiber, and that's why cotton is having minimum moisture regain, that is around 0.4% only. And that's why polyester is generally blended with cotton or viscose to make the textile materials more hygroscopic, because polyester is a very, very hydrophobic fiber. And because this is very hydrophobic, it is not comfortable to wear. That's why we are blending cotton or viscose, which is having high hygroscopic properties or hydrophilic fibers. So purpose of blending is to get homogeneous properties, to get all the properties which is required for that particular end use. Like for apparel purposes, for clothing purposes, we require good strength as well as good hygroscopic property. So to get a good tenacity and good hygroscopic property, for tenacity we are using this polyester, which is stronger fiber, and we are blending with viscose, which is a weaker fiber. So tenacity will be compensated by polyester, whereas hygroscopic property, water absorption property, moisture absorption property will be compensated or will be enhanced by viscose. And that's why polyester viscose blend is a very popular blend in the market. Next is, yes, highly crystalline polymer system do not permit ready entry of water molecules. Yeah, I'm already let you can, just I will read out. Highly crystalline polymer system, like polyester, nylon, all these fibers, do not permit ready entry of water molecules. Water molecules bahut easily usme enter nahi karenge, even if the polymers are polar. Ye maine example diya tha aapko nylon ka. Nylon ka crystalline polymer system hai. However, uske jo polymers hai polar hai, so they will attract the water molecules due to polar nature. But easy entry is not possible, and that's why water absorption property of nylon is lesser as compared to other hygroscopic fibers, other amorphous fibers. The hydrophobic nature of the highly oriented or crystalline fibers give rise to static electricity. This is another minus point or a drawback associated with highly crystalline fibers, that it gives rise to static electricity. Means development of static charges will be more in case of like polyester and these fibers. This is absent in amorphous fibers. Jo ki amorphous fibers mein static electricity generation ke chances minimum ya lagbhag absent nahi hoga. This is absent in amorphous fibers due to moisture absorbency. It is for this reason that the amorphous fibers are blended with the more crystalline fibers to make the latter more comfortable to wear. That I have already explained. Yes, thermal behaviors and thermal properties of fibers. Important thermal property is the temperature at which it may soften and begin to melt. Means kis temperature hum expose kare textile materials ko, either it is yarn or fabric, किस टेम्परेचर तक हम उसको एक्सपोज करेंगे कि वो सॉफ्टन होना या डिग्रेड होना स्टार्ट हो जाएगा और इट विल स्टार्ट टू मेल्ट होना स्टार्ट हो जाएगा. दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी, सो दैट वी कैन डिसाइड द एक्सपोजर टू दोज टेक्सटाइल मटेरियल्स टू पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर. like you have, if you have seen iron in your home, everyone I think has seen iron. तो उसमें कुछ आयरन्स जो होती हैं उनमें टेम्परेचर सेट करने के लिए होता है. वो टेम्परेचर सेट करने का पर्पज़ ये होता है कि आप किस मटेरियल को आयरन करने जा रहे हो, कॉटन को कर रहे हो, विस्कोस मटेरियल को कर रहे हो या पॉलिएस्टर को कर रहे हो, उसके अकॉर्डिंग उसका जो थर्मल बिहेवियर है, अगर उससे ज़्यादा टेम्परेचर आपने रखा तो डिग्रेडेशन के चांसेज हैं, सॉफ्ट होने के चांसेज हैं पॉलीमर के. और अगर पॉलीमर सॉफ्टन या मेल्ट होना स्टार्ट होगा तो जो टेक्सटाइल मटेरियल उससे बनाया हुआ है वो डिग्रेड हो जाएगा या डिस्टॉर्ट हो जाएगा. दिस इज अ रिलेटिव मेजर ऑफ द फाइबर्स हीट रेजिस्टेंस. फाइबर कितना हीट के प्रति रेजिस्टेंस प्रोवाइड करता है उसका एक रिलेटिव मेजर है दिस थर्मल बिहेवियर विच इज टेकन एज सॉफ्टनिंग टेम्परेचर एंड मेल्टिंग टेम्परेचर, मेल्टिंग पॉइंट और सॉफ्टनिंग पॉइंट. द सॉफ्टनिंग एंड मेल्टिंग पॉइंट टेम्परेचर ऑफ अ फाइबर आर रिलेटेड टू द क्रिस्टलिनिटी ऑफ द पॉलीमर सिस्टम. Again, crystalline and amorphous regions is an important parameter, is an important considerations as far as thermal behaviors of fibers are concerned. Hence, more heat or kinetic energy will be required to free polymers from each other. Polymers ke beech mein bonds hain. Agar uske andar crystalline polymer system hai, to jyada bonds honge, polymer aligned honge, polymer ke beech mein bonds jyada honge, to displacement easy nahi hoga. Usko agar displace karna hai, to hume ज़्यादा काइनेटिक एनर्जी की जरूरत पड़ेगी या ज़्यादा हीट की जरूरत पड़ेगी. इट मीन्स जिनका पॉलीमर सिस्टम हाईली क्रिस्टलाइन है वो फाइबर्स टेम्परेचर को ज़्यादा रेजिस्ट कर सकते हैं. इट मीन्स ग्रेटर रेजिस्टेंस टू हीट अगर क्रिस्टलाइन फाइबर क्रिस्टलाइन पॉलीमर सिस्टम है फाइबर का तो. एंड सॉफ्टनिंग एंड मेल्टिंग एट हाई टेम्परेचर. सो मोर द क्रिस्टलाइन melting and softening temperature will be high, means it can be exposed to higher temperatures. But if it is more amorphous regions, then less kinetic energy or less heat is required for the displacement of the polymers, and it will be lesser resistance to heat, means softening and melting temperatures will be lesser as compared to crystalline fibers. So thermal behaviors, thermal properties mainly depending on proportion of crystalline and amorphous regions within the polymer system of the fiber. And the last property, that is chemical properties or chemical behaviors. This gives an indication of the extent to which the polymers of a fiber may react with the common degrading agents, such as the alkalis of laundering liquids. लॉन्ड्रिंग में जो हम एल्कालीज जो सॉप यूज करते हैं वो भी एक तरह से डिग्रेडिंग एजेंट हैं. तो उसको कितना रेजिस्ट कर पा रहा है टेक्सटाइल मटेरियल या फाइबर. एसिड्स, एटमॉस्फेरिक पॉल्यूशन, सॉइलिंग, सनलाइट एंड इवन वेदर कंडीशंस, ऑल दीज आर कंसिडर्ड इनटू केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज. मीन्स हाउ द फाइबर इज रिएक्टिंग विद ऑल दीज डिग्रेडिंग एजेंट्स. Means it is highly resistant or it is less resistant. If it is highly resistant to all these degrading agents, we will say it is having good chemical properties. Means it is highly chemically resistant fiber. And if these are lacking into a fiber, then we will say we can say that this fiber is having less resistance to chemicals. And if it is having less resistance to chemicals, then in day to day use when it is exposed to laundry or it is exposed to higher temperatures at ironing or when we are drying the cloths or when it is exposed to soils or when it is exposed to atmospheric pollution, it will not withstand all these, it will not be resistant to these, and the textile materials will be easily degraded, means their life will be shortened and also the quality will get deteriorated. And that's why we require a good chemically resistant fibers. Fiber chemical properties are directly influenced by the ratio of amorphous and crystalline regions. In all the slides you can see this is a very common point, this is a very important point. The polymer system is highly crystalline or amorphous, that is going to affect all the properties. Fiber with a more crystalline polymer system tends to chemically more resistant than fibers with a more amorphous regions. जो फाइबर्स ज्यादा क्रिस्टलाइन पॉलीमर सिस्टम है जिसके अंदर, उनका रेजिस्टेंस उन फाइबर से ज्यादा होगा जो कि अमोर्फस पॉलीमर सिस्टम जिनमें है. मोर क्रिस्टलाइन फाइबर्स मेक इट वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर डाई मॉलिक्यूल्स टू एंटर द पॉलीमर सिस्टम ऑफ द फाइबर, बट दिस इज एन एडवर्स पॉइंट. केमिकल रेजिस्टेंस अगर ज्यादा है तो रेजिस्टेंट टू डाई मॉलिक्यूल्स इज विल बी ऑल्सो हाई, एंड दैट इज अ ड्रॉबैक फॉर दैट फाइबर. एंड फॉर दैट वी हैव सम स्पेसिफिक डाइंग टेक्निक्स टू डाई दोज फाइबर्स, एंड दैट इंक्रीजेज द कॉस्ट ऑफ द मटेरियल्स. सो दैट इज ड्रॉबैक एसोसिएटेड विद हाईली केमिकली रेजिस्टेंट फाइबर्स. सो हाईली केमिकल रेजिस्टेंट फाइबर वी प्रीफर, बट डाइंग ऑफ दोज फाइबर्स विल बी डिफिकल्ट, एंड वी रिक्वायर स्पेसिफिक प्रोसेसेस टू डाई देम, एंड इट इंक्रीज, इट एड ऑन द कॉस्टिंग ऑफ द टेक्सटाइल मटेरियल्स, मीन्स कॉस्ट विल गेट इंक्रीज्ड. So friends, we have completed this topic, and this was the last topic from the first unit. Now, if you have any questions, you can ask, because we have 5-6 minutes more. Any question?
सेकंड वाला एरो समझा दो ना, टेंड्स टू केमिकली वाला.
व्हिच वन? केमिकल रेजिस्टेंस
केमिकली. हाँ, ये सेकंड पॉइंट है, सेकंड एरो.